Sup HSTAT, my name is Jordi Simbana, and I'm here to introduce to you for the very first time ever, the Video Production Club. So with this club, we aim to deliver fun and creative content for all of you to enjoy, but also showing you the bigger idea of what producing a video is all about. Allow me to clarify, video production isn't just holding a camera and pressing the record button, but instead it is the creative idea behind what you're filming and wanting to share what is on your mind. And so what you're about to see right now is our club's creative minds coming together and bringing you this awesome introduction. And so without further ado, I present to you our first video. Enjoy.
Hi HSTAT, I'm Brianna Grijalvo.
I'm Andrew Lin.
And I'm Karen Gonzalez, and welcome to
What's
the
Buzz?
We are excited to launch our first episode ever of our first student-run broadcast to our HSTAT community. We will be your HSTAT news anchors. This school year certainly hasn't been like past years. As we engage in remote learning during the COVID pandemic, we hope to provide a fun source of entertainment for our HSTAT community and to make you feel included and informed during these tough times of remote learning.
Absolutely. Although we have been remote, it doesn't change the HSTAT spirit. Let's take a look at some of the great initiatives that's happened at HSTAT these past few months. On October 30th, the student government and Ms. Beck, coordinator of student activity, planned HSTAT's first Halloween virtual party where students can make friends and celebrate Halloween together. Our students had a chance to collaborate and play Among Us, join a craft room, go through a haunted house tour, jam out to music, and hear some haunted house stories and watch some spooky movies. The night ended with a meditation and some great laughs and dead crewmates.
Thank you, SGO and Ms. Beck, for coordinating this thrilling night. Another highlight from November to celebrate fall and Thanksgiving was Art Club's participation in the 68th annual Bay Ridge Window Painting Competition with the guidance of Ms. Giardinella, Art Club advisor. Art Club members created fall-themed artwork and painted them on the windows of the Bay Ridge Family Eye Care Optical Store located on 3rd Avenue. Each artist received a gold medal and added beauty to the streets of Bay Ridge. I personally, as an Art Club member, love this experience, and we did not let the rain stop us. Let's hear from Art Club member DeSalle Tapia about her painting experience.
We're at the Bay Ridge annual window painting competition.
Yes.
I'm supposed to be a turkey with eyeglasses because obviously we're at the family eye care.
It's so nice to see the art club getting involved in a community. Speaking of getting involved, HSTAT, you made your voices heard. Thank you to all of the students who participated in the SGO's most recent initiative of collecting your feedback on remote learning. The feedback will truly be valuable in enhancing our remote experience as the school year continues.
It has also been a busy time for the college office and our seniors as well. On November 23rd, the class of 2021 made final decisions about where they want to go to college and submitted their college applications. The seniors then celebrated this milestone during their English class by dressing up and taking application day photos. Ms. Dumaresk and Ms. Sherpa, our college advisors, have been working hard to make sure all applications are complete and sent in on time. Let's check in with Ms. Dumaresk now, who has a little help with the process from her puppy, Hogan.
Ms. Sherpa and I are so proud of you guys for getting this done. We weren't sure how this was going to go this year. And when we had application day, we weren't sure how many students were actually going to turn their applications in. And as of right now, all but 30 seniors have applied to college. And so that is huge. And that was a lot of work both from us, but really on your part as well. So you guys really kind of stepped up and got things done. You read the tutorials, you came to your meetings. And so we were really, really impressed with you guys and with your level of kind of commitment to getting this done, even in the midst of a pandemic and doing things virtually. So the next steps, after doing all your applications and your financial aid and applying to scholarships, it's really just, we're waiting. You're gonna wait to get your acceptance letters and then also to get financial aid packages to see how much money you're getting from the colleges and then making a decision about where you wanna go. So by May 1st, you'll commit to a college and then you'll start doing all of the registration at that college, attending the meetings at the colleges, meeting with your advisors, making your schedules and all of that. So between now and May 1st, it's a lot of waiting to hear back from the schools. I think my advice is really to start thinking and researching as soon as possible, because the more work you get done as a freshman, sophomore, and junior, the easier your senior year will be. So the more research you do, the better idea you'll have of what kind of college you want to go to. Also, if you know that you want to go to a school, you can kind of work to make sure that your grades are where they need to be in order to get into those colleges. So kind of really motivating yourself to get the grades you need in order to get into the school you want. And also you can start thinking about your college essay and all of that as soon as junior year, I would say, start working on your college essay so that once you get to senior year, you can focus on just really completing your applications. You don't have to do the whole research process. You don't have to be first trying to come up with an idea of writing your essay. You have a lot of that background stuff done already so that you can just do the hard work of actually filling out the applications. Ms. Sherpa and I love working in the college office. We'd love helping you guys kind of move towards this next step. And we're here for anyone that needs help. Please do not be afraid to email us or to set up a Zoom meeting with us, because that's what we're here for. So we want to help you with any process that you need. So take advantage of us. But also, like, please be reading your emails. Please respond to us when we are emailing you guys. There's 300 of you and there's only two of us. And so when we're emailing and not getting any responses, that can be hard and frustrating. So please, please be responsive, communicate with us. Let us know how we can help you so that you can have as successful and as easy of a college application process as possible. And class of 2021, just congratulations on all the work you've done so far. We really are so proud of you guys for working through this pandemic, getting these college applications done, and also done so early that you guys will see, you'll start getting your acceptance letters soon, and you'll have nothing but excitement and celebration for the months coming up. So we're proud of you. We love working with you guys. And please email us if you need help.
Looks like Hogan did a lot of helping. Seniors, if you have quick college questions, the college office is having office hours from 1 through 2 p.m. each day this week. Or you can schedule an appointment with a college advisor for more detailed questions. Check your HSTAT emails for more information. The HSTAT community has certainly been active in keeping us connected, even when we have to be apart. Not only is this our first episode of What's the Buzz, but it is also our holiday edition. As the holidays are among us, and we're all looking forward to the break, and in the spirit of the holidays, we had the opportunity to learn from Ms. Warsdale, the ninth grade algebra teacher, senior mentor program coordinator, and former culinary club advisor, how to make apple crisp, one of her holiday recipes.
So, for the easy apple crisp recipe, we're gonna start with the topping. Now, we got half a cup of flour, you know, bring it over to the bowl, don't want to spill it on the ground. Right, and look at that, we're gonna do half a cup of brown sugar too. Okay, so we're gonna take the cinnamon, Okay, we're gonna take that. Alright, hold it again. Now we're gonna go with the salt, okay? So just a little cube butter. I cubed it, so I'm gonna put it in here, okay? I took the crumb topping and I put it in the fridge, so that is chilling. I also took about 2 pounds of apples and I peeled them all, okay? So I peeled them so there's no skin and then I just diced them. We are gonna take the melted butter, put it in this little mixing bowl. Okay. 2 tablespoons of flour. Okay, one tablespoon, that's 1 tablespoon. Okay, so I'm gonna put in 1 tablespoon. All right, so now it's calling for 3 tablespoons of water. You think we're making lemonade instead of pineapple crisp over here, huh? So we're gonna add 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Light brown sugar too, not dark brown sugar. To be honest, I don't know if it really makes a difference, but I'm just following the recipe, you know. So we're gonna do 1/4 cup of this. 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon. A pinch of salt. Use a fork. Whisk it around there a little bit. I'm just gonna pour this mixture over. Look at that. I'm just so good there. I'm just gonna coat the apples nicely. Just gonna stir it around. You wanna make sure all the apples get the flavor they need. So then I'm gonna take my coated apples. I'm gonna pour them into my prepared dish. Prepared meaning you can grease it if you'd like. I sprayed a little bit of Pam in it, just a little bit. Take out our prepared apple crumble topping. I really like it. So it's just nice and crumbly. Let's take this, I'm gonna pour it on. Just make sure we spread it all out, okay? I preheated the oven to 375. Okay, 35 minutes.
A few moments later.
Oh, there's my glasses, and we're gonna pick that up. I don't know if that's proper. All right, and we have a nice bubbling apple crisp here. So it's nice and bubbling. Got, so here we have the little dish. We got a little ice cream, the crumble with the sauce. So let's try it out. Here we go. It's actually really good. And have a happy holiday.
Now that looks delicious. Ms. Swarzel, thank you for sharing your favorite holiday recipe with us. One thing that certainly hasn't changed since being remote is that this is HSTAT's season of giving. We had the opportunity to check in with the Blueprint Leadership Club to learn more about their initiative this holiday season, Operation Santa.
Blueprint Leadership Club is really about leadership, as it says, but it's also about being able to have a focus on self-development. I mean, the simplest definition of a leader is someone who wishes to be followed. But in order to be someone who is followed, you have to have certain qualities and characteristics. So we work throughout the year in 4 different phases, ranging from self-development to community involvement, to school involvement, to global issues. We try to work through those 4 phases so that, you know, we can develop ourselves as leaders. So really, that's what it's about, self-development and impacting others. My favorite part of this whole experience is having students decide that they're going to start to see themselves having an impact on others. Like they want to lead so that they can help others to reach their goals. So when they make that commitment to work together for the betterment of everyone else, that tends to be my favorite part. And also staying in touch with a lot of them, because Blueprint tends to be a family, not just a club. So I like hearing from members that, you know, started with us 9 years ago. It's always fun to do that. Okay, this year I will say is really exciting and different because we are fully virtual. We started that way. So it enabled us to start looking at other groups around the school that we can work with. So we decided that our focus was going to be volunteering. So it's been a great experience so far to be able to meet with many new members this term and to start developing different options for volunteering with students who are not so engaged with the Zoom platform, who really wish we were back in school. So we're working on different types of workshops and activities to help them feel engaged, but also to help them with technical issues and just tutoring and just being able to communicate virtually. So it's been exciting working with that.
Okay. My name is Abigail. I'm a junior and I joined this club to engage into the school community and give back and help others.
Hi, I'm Z. I am currently a senior and I've been Blueprint since sophomore year. And my position in Blueprint right now is currently administrator / member. I first joined this club because I was recommended by a friend of mine, and I thought that it would be a good experience to get involved with the community more, because freshman year I was kind of just looking for clubs to have fun, but sophomore year I really wanted to work on my character. Operation Santa was created as an alternative to Gift of Giving, which we would usually do in person, and this year we decided that we will fulfill two kids' wishes, because they wrote two letters, and the school is collecting funds from teachers and those 18 plus to help them buy gifts and hopefully be able to fulfill what they want in their letters.
We've been helping to spread information about the Operation Santa so that other students can help and contribute money so that we can help these students who need gifts for Christmas.
Yeah, adding on to what Abigail said, because we're students, we can't really donate with our credit cards. So our main focus has been trying to spread this to teachers and those 18 plus, because they have credit cards and we don't. So that has been our main way of helping spread our operation.
What a great way to bring joy this holiday season. Thank you to Ms. Mayo and the Blueprint Club for running this great initiative. The season of giving continues, and our very own Jenny Chang had the opportunity to virtually visit Link Club to learn more about Dollars for Dinner, a collaboration with the SGO.
Hello everyone, I'm Jenny Chang from What's the Buzz. Today we have three special guests, Mr. XV, Miriam and Sarah, and they're here to discuss their Link's participation for Dinners for Dollars. First question we have, what is Link Club and what has Link Club been up to virtually?
I think I'll start. So Link Club is basically a club in our school, and we meet Thursdays at 3 p.m. and we kind of just all come together and find ways to like get involved in the school or get students involved. And one thing that we did so far, like in the past, was for Valentine's Day, we raised money. So like someone would buy a bag of chocolate and it'd be like a dollar and we'd send it out. So far this year, we've done Dollars for Dinner. And it's kind of like a fundraiser, and all the money we've raised is going to people like that need food and all the issues with COVID.
What is Dollars for Dinner?
Dollars for Dinner is a fundraiser that the Link Club has organized to send all the money that is raised. It's going to go to COPO, which is a organization where they are helping people in New York City right now who are in a crisis because of the pandemic. So they distributed more than 60 million pounds of food. So all the money that's donated to the Dollars for Dinner, it's going to go to COPO, which they help people in New York City right now during the pandemic with the food.
We have a GoFundMe page, and the GoFundMe page is linked to the HSTAT account. It's a link. And basically, everyone's just donating a dollar or however much they can donate, and all that money is going to go to COPO, which is going to help everyone in New York.
Wow, you guys are really considerate. I really love that. Okay. So the third question is, what is one of the most proud moments of being part of Dollars for Dinner?
I would say helping the community, because I really like helping other people. So it's a good thing. When I saw that we raised more than $1,600, that like really made me happy because it's gonna go and it's gonna help other people in need.
For me personally, I think the proudest moments was just, of course, like helping other people, but knowing that we can come all together during this hard time and like find something that could be productive. Because I know in the beginning, it was really hard for us to get access or like to get into contact with other people to like find a foundation, something we can do. So I think like looking back at it now, like a couple weeks ago, we weren't really sure what we were gonna do. So now looking back at that, we already raised over $1,000. So I think that's like really, like a really good moment to be proud of.
I'll share one thing. Link Club started thinking about food insecurity because of this COVID crisis, you know, I think probably in like September, October. And we were in the process of putting together a food can drive. And we had vigorous debates in our meetings about what people needed most. Is it toys? Is it coats? Should we be working with Blueprint and SGO? How can we help? You know, our mission is to help our community. And we were literally at the point of creating a food can drive the week that we went remote, right? So that the first meeting after like going fully remote was like a little bit grim, right? Miriam and Sarah, right? It was like, oh, what do we do now, right? COPO, the organization that we're fundraising for, was featured in a New York Times podcast that I could send you, Jenny. And it just got us thinking about maybe ways we can raise money for, you know, for a food pantry. And I think when we first had the conversation on the call, because we were worried that, you know, who's going to donate to this, we thought, well, if everyone gets two people or three people to donate a buck or two, maybe we could raise $200 or $300. We thought that would be a success. And at this point, we've raised already over $1,600.
Yeah, I think we just kept getting shut down, like meeting after meeting. There was like an issue, whether it was like we wouldn't, like school getting shut down, so we couldn't do the canned food drive. And then when we found a place, they weren't responding back. So I feel like after like the third time that we got shut down, it was kind of like, well, what are we supposed to do? But I feel like with COPO and how much money we raised already, I think it's going to be like such a good view on Link Club. Because if I'm not mistaken, I think this is the most money we've raised in Link Club history. And in the first day, we raised like $1,000, if I'm not mistaken. And our limit was really $100, maybe even $200 max. And in that first day, we raised $1,000. So.
Wow, that's really impressive, though. Okay, but that's just the last question. We're done. So thank you so much for Mr. Exbrig, Miriam, and Sarah for joining us.
It's really great to see our school community giving back during such a time of need. Great job, HSTAT. We all know that life during a pandemic and quarantine can be difficult, but can be even more difficult during the holiday season. I know one of my favorite holiday traditions is to watch a Charlie Brown Christmas every night on Christmas with my uncle while drinking my mom's hot chocolate. How about you?
My favorite traditions are putting up the Christmas tree and making Christmas cookies and gingerbread houses with my family.
That sounds wonderful. My favorite family tradition is having my extended family over for dinner. It's really fun and like crowded in my house when they are here.
We could all definitely use a positivity now more than ever. This is why the HSTAT community has come together to wish you all best wishes during the holiday season and share some of their favorite holiday traditions or quarantine activity. Let's take a look.
Hi! We hope that you guys have a great break. Happy holidays, and we'll see you soon. Bye!
Happy holidays, everyone. Merry Christmas. This is my favorite time of the year. I love the decorations, my fireplace in the background, my lights, the decorations. I absolutely love it. I especially love spending the time with my family. Every Christmas, the children and I would get up early, would have breakfast, open our gifts, And so that's one set of gifts. And then we would leave and travel to Connecticut, where another set of gifts are waiting for us. This year is very difficult. I have not seen my mom that much because of COVID. And we've also lost family members and friends. And so I know it's going to be a very, very trying year. You know, the holidays in general is a very, very difficult time for most people because of losses. And sometimes they're not near their family members. So it's hard. It's definitely hard. But this is where we come in, right? If you know that your friends are sad because they're not near their family, then you know what? Be their temporary family. Reach out to them. Sometimes all we need is just to know that people out there care. Just by the word that we, just by a word, a call, just reaching out. And so if you can do that for someone, then do that, right? Enjoy the time with your family and friends. Have a great holiday, everyone. Be well.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ms. DiBernardo, and I'd like to wish you all a happy holidays in 2020. And I wanted to show you some of the ways that I'm getting ready to celebrate the holidays this year. I've started decorating, and I've started some shopping. And even though I'm a Spanish teacher, I'm Italian. So one of the traditions, we eat some special foods for the holidays. And in my family in particular, we eat this special pasta called fusilli. And even though it's available all year round, we only eat it on Christmas. So it's not Christmas yet, but I have it in my house because I'm getting ready, and I will cook it and eat it on Christmas Day, this fusilli. Another thing I wanted to show you was this panettone. It's another traditional Italian food for Christmas especially. And this year, being a small crowd, I have a mini panettone, and I will have this for breakfast on Christmas Day. So in Italian, I will sign off by saying Buone feste, Buon Natale. And in Spanish, I will say Feliz Navidad. And in English, I will wish you all a happy holiday season. And we hope to see you in 2021.
Hello, everyone at HSTAT. I wanted to wish you all a happy holiday season and a happy new year. I hope everyone has a great time, hopefully with families, friends, enjoying a safe, fun holiday. I also wanted to say my favorite holiday snack. So this was a hard thing for me to think about. I think my favorite holiday snacks are, I love hot cocoa, and I love hot cocoa accompanied with chocolate chip cookies. Definitely gets me in the holiday spirit, and I love it during these cold winter months. So yeah, that's about me. Bye guys.
Hi, Kelly community. I just want to take this opportunity to wish everybody the season's greetings and all the best for 2021 and the new year.
Hey, HSTAT. My favorite Christmas tradition is hanging out and having dinner with my family on Christmas Eve. Times are tough this year and different, but we're still keeping the Christmas spirit. Stay safe, stay healthy, and happy holidays.
Greetings from Eastport. This is Jeffrey, a.k.a. Mr. Osler, wishing you the happiest holiday. This season, don't let anything take away your joy. Together we'll get through this. Peace on earth and goodwill to all.
Hi everybody. I just want to wish everyone a very happy holiday season and a very healthy new year.
Hi Yellow Jackets, it's Ms. Sherpa. I know this year is not at all what you expected, but we are so proud of you for continuing to maintain such a positive outlook on life, even in these very uncertain times. Please keep yourself and your families safe during this holiday season. And on behalf of the college office, my partners, Ms. Dumarask, Ms. Maureen, and I would love to wish you and your family a restful, restful break. We hope to be reunited with you in the year 2021. We love you guys and we miss you so much. Happy holidays.
Hi, HSTAT. Just want to wish you all a very happy holidays. Miss you.
Hey, HSTAT students. I hope you have a wonderful and relaxing holiday and a happy new year.
So here are some ways that I like to spread holiday cheer. So first and foremost, I like to look for treasure in silver and gold. I like to save sinking ships and shipwrecked arcana. I like thinking outside of the box in just one, and I keep getting these upside down. I like safely securing my spies and code names. I like living my best pirate life in forgotten waters. I like building paths to victory in five tribes. I like arguing for endangered animals to the UN in endangered. I like to be the strongest monster in King of Tokyo. I like to cheer on the Amazons as they bend the mascara in Wonder Woman. I like to stand against evil in Marvel United. I like to fight for the best possible timeline in Back to the Future. I like to think of the most colorful clues in Hues and Cues. And lastly, I like to uncover mysteries in Mansions of Madness. So these are some ways I enjoy spreading holiday cheer.
Hi, HSTAT crew. So for the holidays, I'm gonna tell you about my favorite holiday tradition. And so my favorite holiday tradition and my tree behind me to show you is that about 9 years ago, my husband and I started a tradition with my oldest son that we would pick a specific ornament every year that represented something we were into or something that we just liked that we saw or something that just came to our eye, because we wanted our tree to be representative of our family. And so I'm gonna show you some of them with my kids. So you get to see my kids. So my oldest, what's your favorite?
So this was my first one, and it's Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer because I watched that one.
Thank you, Brendan. Lucas, can you show your favorite?
My favorite is the spider.
Good job. And that's my husband. Can you choose your favorite?
Hello. My favorite is the Santa Claus right here holding the Coca-Cola bottle, and that is because the first Santa Claus I ever met in real life was in Macy's handing out Coca-Colas.
And my favorite is my running ornament, because I feel like I overcame something that was really tough to become better at it. So it always reminds me that I'm strong and I can overcome. Thank you guys, bye.
On behalf of our student government, I want to say I hope that you all have a relaxing and restorative winter break, a happy new year, and that you come back in 2021 excited to be a part of our Tele community.
My name is Mr. Mennick, and I'm a teacher at HSTAT. And I'm here to say that my favorite holiday snack is Happy holidays.
Since it's snowing outside. Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
We go on.
Are you listening?
down the lane, snow is glistening, a beautiful sight, we're happy tonight.
Here
it
is, 2021.
The bluebird here to stay is the new bird. He sings a love song.
We hope this segment brought a little bit of hope and positivity to you all this holiday season. All of us from the Video Production Club want to continue spreading holiday cheer and celebrate our first episode premiere. We thought about how we could do both. We are excited to present this feature from the Video Production Club this holiday season. We hope you enjoy it. Thank you all for joining us today. I am Brianna Grijalva.
I am Andrew Lynn.
And I am Karen Gonzalez. Thanks for watching, HSTAT. Catch us our next episode of
What's
the
Buzz?
Remember, this week is Spirit Week. Tomorrow is Twin Day and with friends and family. And Wednesday is Ugly Sweater Day. So participate in Holiday Spirit Week.
And to close out our episode, enjoy some student-created holiday art from the Art Club.
Sleigh bells ring, I am listening. In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland.
Gone away is the bluebird. Here to stay is the new bird. He sings a love song as we go along, walking in the winter wonderland.
In the meadow we can build a snowman and pretend that he is passing around.
He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no man, but you can do the job when you're in town.
Later on we'll conspire
as we dream by the fire
to face unafraid the blizzard.